After colonizing Mars, the next step of human civilization on space should be a space city. But with current technology, we are far from building a self-sufficient base in empty space. In this video, I will show you four technologies of the future that will help humanity build an entire space city. Let's start with artificial gravity. It may still sound like a fictional technology, but it is not. It is possible to create artificial gravity with the technology we already have. But why do we need it? Although being weightless is an amazing experience, it has some negative effects on the human body. To build a space city where humans will live permanently, we will need artificial gravity. The method requires a frame that can rotate. The rotation will provide centrifugal force. It's the same force you feel when you try to drive a car in a curved way. When the car is moving in a straight line, nothing happens. But as soon as the car enters a curve that bends to the left, the passengers in the car experience an apparent force to the right. Similarly, the astronauts inside the rotating frame will feel a force in the opposite direction of the center of rotation. This will be exactly like gravitational pull. Many science fiction movies have already shown entire space cities built using this technology. But creating such a rotating space station in real life would be very difficult and expensive. To simulate Earth's gravitational pull, it has to be almost half a kilometer in diameter. For now, scientists have planned to build a smaller rotating frame which will be able to provide at least half of the gravitational pull of Earth. But in the future, if we are going to create entire cities in space, we will need to use this technology at its full strength. To build such a giant structure, we will need a lot of resources. We cannot take all the resources from Earth. First of all, Earth has limited resources. Besides, it will be extremely costly to transport all those resources to space. Therefore, we need to harvest the resources in space. That brings us to the next technology in the list. Asteroid mining. This is not exactly a technology. We have to develop several technologies to make asteroid mining a reality. Asteroids are basically rocks, metals, and ice left over from the cloud that formed the planets 4.5 billion years ago. Asteroids are all over the solar system, with most of them concentrating in the asteroid belt and the Kuiper belt. There are both big and small asteroids containing trillions of ore, industrial and precious metals. By mining those metals, we can not only build whatever we want, but also cover the whole world's metal needs for years. Besides, it will also save the environment, as mining on Earth causes air and water pollution. Dangerous chemicals that are used to extract the metals damage the environment as well as the locals. Asteroid mining can be a clean source of rare and precious metals, but with current technology, it would cost more to extract the metals than the value of them. This is gonna be a big challenge for humanity. Building any base out of Earth would require asteroid mining, as it is gonna be the easiest and most available way to get the resources. But even if we can develop technologies to successfully extract metals from the asteroids, we will still need to transport people from Earth. With the effort of companies like SpaceX, the cost of sending humans to space is reducing rapidly. But it's still far from the point where normal people would be able to go to space. There might be a solution for this in the next technology. The space elevator. Instead of launching a whole rocket every time we send something to space, why don't we just build an elevator long enough to send stuff directly into space? Although it will be extremely expensive to build such a thing, once built, it will make space travel extremely affordable even for normal people to go to space, for a vacation maybe. It may sound crazy at first, but if you think about it, we already have long elevators in tall buildings. The tallest building in the world right now is Burj Khalifa, which is about 829 meters long. And a successful space elevator needs to be at least 35,786 kilometers long. The reason it needs to be so long is that a giant structure like this cannot be supported by only a base in the ground. It must be supported from space. This is called the counterweight, which can be a geostationary space station. It needs to move at the same speed as the Earth's rotation. The centrifugal force provided by the rotation will pull the tether from upside. So a full space elevator will have four major parts: the ground base, the counterweight, the tether that will connect the ground base and the counterweight, and a climber that will climb the tether. With our current technology, it is possible to build three parts of the elevator: the ground base, the counterweight, and the climber. But the tether, which is the most important part, we don't have material strong enough to build the tether. We need something that is about 100 times stronger than steel, and it must be much lighter. There is no chance for mistake. If somehow the tether breaks, it can cause big problems. We have to do it right at the first try. Scientists thought of using carbon nanotube, but according to newer studies, it may also not do the job. So a space elevator will not be a reality soon. But we can hope for the best. Maybe in a few years we will find the technology to build the tether. Until then, we need something that is more of a reality. Here comes the next technology in the list: the Starship. After all these futuristic, unbelievable technologies, let's look at a technology that is more familiar. It's a rocket. Not just any rocket, it's the most powerful rocket ever built by humans. After so many launches of SpaceX's Starship, it may not look very special to you, but actually it is much more advanced than any rocket we had a few years ago. Starship is part of NASA's $2.9 billion deal with SpaceX. The goal was to develop a fully reusable launch vehicle, which is incredibly powerful. And it has actually come up to the expectations. Not only it is powerful, it is also cost-efficient at the same time. NASA's space shuttle STS-135, which is the closest thing we ever had to a Starship, cost about $576 million to $1.64 billion per launch. On the other hand, the Starship costs only $28 million per launch. And Elon Musk wants to cut down the cost to an unbelievable $2 million in the future. Whatever we're gonna do in space, say it colonizing the moon and Mars, mining asteroids, or building a space city, the Starship will be an incredible help to humanity in the near future. The SN20 is the latest Starship, which is going to become the first Starship to make an orbital flight. The Starship has a huge internal pressurized space. It can carry a huge amount of cargo and also humans depending on the applications. According to SpaceX, there is space for 40 passenger cabins, common areas, storage space, and a shelter to hide from solar storms. It can comfortably hold 100 people to Mars, and even more depending on the mission. If we're going to build a space city, we will need to transport a lot of people to space. Until we build something like a space elevator, Starship can play a crucial role to get the job done. It's already amazing to think about a spaceship carrying 100 astronauts roaming around space. Now it feels like science fiction happening in front of our eyes.